Hello everyone, hope you all are doing good. So in today's video we'll discuss the another problem of payroll statement. So let's go to the question. So this is the question on the payroll. So we have given the format. So in this format we have to prepare the payroll statements, and also we have given the various information for the calculation purpose. And in this question we have to prepare the payroll statement for 10 employees. So now let's move to the solution. So this is the format that we have already given in the question. So the employee ID, name of employee, experience, HRA payable, basic, DA, HRA, and gross PF tax and surcharge in total tax and net, that is the gross minus PF plus to minus total tax. So I have randomly taken the employee ID, 10 employees ID, and also the name also, and I have allotted the different number of experience randomly. And similarly I have assigned Y for the yes if the HRA is payable, and N is for the no if HRA is not payable, and this is also allotted randomly. Now for the basic I have assigned this values randomly, so this is not given in the question. So now moves to the calculation part. The first item that we need to calculate is the DA. Now in the question the condition or the calculation for DA is given that DNS allowance for those who have experience up to 5 years is 80% of basic, subject to a maximum of 10,000, and for other it is 200% of basic, subject to a maximum of 25,000. So that means the employee is entitled to 80% of basic or 10,000, whichever is less if the experience is up to 5 years. Otherwise he will be entitled to 25,000 or 200% of basic, whichever is less. So in this for DA we will be using the minimum function. So first we need to apply the if function for the experience. So is equals to if this experience is less than and equals to 5, then minimum will be, first is 80% of basic, fine. So here we need to select 0.8 multiply by this, or he will be entitled to 10,000, so whichever is less. Otherwise he will be entitled to 200% of basic, otherwise 25,000. So in this way we'll be using the formula for calculating DNS allowance. So what we are saying here, if this experience is less than, so I think I have taken the wrong cell, so we need to select, okay no, this is fine. So if this experience is less than equals to 5, then it should be minimum of this value, otherwise it should be minimum of this value. If you enter it, the DA is calculated, and for the others implies you can simply drag it, fine. So in this way we'll comply all the condition for calculation of DA. Now moves to the HRA part. So the condition for HRA is given that it is paid 70% of basic up to 10,000 if HRA payable to the employee, else no HRA is paid. So in this we can say if we are paying HRA to the employees, then he will be entitled to 70% of basic, but also there are a condition that the basic should be up to 10,000. So here we need to apply the if and function, because there are two conditions, that HRA option should be payable, that is yes, and the second will be the basic should be less than and equals to 10,000. So here I'm using the if function. So is equals to if the first, again we need to use and, because there are two conditions. So first condition is if this option is equals to in inverted comma y, that is for the yes, and the second will be it should be less than and equals to 10,000. So basic should be less than and equals to 10,000. So there are two conditions must be satisfied. If these two conditions are satisfied, then he will be entitled to 70% of basic, otherwise zero. So this is the formula for HR rate. So if you enter it and if you drag it for the other values, so you will be getting the values. Now you can cross check it. So here the HRA option is yes, fine. And the second condition is that wages should be less than and equals to 10,000. So here if the HRA option is yes and basic should be less than 10,000 but it is exceed 25,000, so that's why it is calculated 0. Now here you can check it, the option is yes, so this condition is satisfied, and the second is it should be less than 10,000 and the salary is less than 10,000, that is 5,000, so that means it calculated correctly. Now we need to calculate the gross. So gross will be equals to basic plus DA plus HRA. So you can simply use the sum function here. So sum of these values and enter, and you can copy this formula to the other cells. Fine. Now we need to calculate the PF. Now the PF is equals to 15% of gross salary. So is equals to 0.15 multiply by gross, then enter, and for the others you can simply copy the formulas. Fine. In this way we'll be getting the PF. Now for the tax, there is a condition that tax should be 30% of gross rounded off to the next higher multiple of. So here I am reapplying the same simple formula, is equals to round. So it should be 30% of gross, and we are going to round off to the higher multiple of 10, so it will be minus 1, then enter. If you drag it, you will get the values to the other cells. Now we need to calculate the additional surcharge, so which is equals to 2% if the income exceed 12,000. So again we are going to use if formula, is equals to if income test, that is this, exceed 12,000, then it will be 0.02% of basic, otherwise it will be 0, then enter. So if you drag it to the other cell, you will get the values, that is the surcharge. Now the total tax will be equals to sum of PF, income tax and surcharge, not PF, only the income tax and surcharge, then enter, and you can drag it to the other cells. So in this way we will be getting the total. Now we will calculate the net. So net will be equals to gross minus surcharge, PF plus total tax, then enter, and you can drag it for the other cell. So in this way we prepare the payroll statement. One more point here is I have calculated surcharge on the basic. Fine. So in this question it is not given on which we have to charge the surcharge, so I have charged on basic. If you are charging to gross, so it is also correct. Fine. So I hope this is clear to all of you. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you very much for watching this, and if you like this video, please do like and subscribe the channel.